Welcome to AP Crane Training. Today we will look at how tower cranes are built and moved. Let's get started. Tower cranes first appeared in 1949. They are essential in the skyline of construction sites and pivotal for building skyscrapers and bridges, symbolizing both strength and precision. The installation process begins with meticulous preparation, involving planning the layout, determining the optimal placement on the construction site, and designing the crane's foundation, which is made out of concrete. Once the site is prepared and foundation set, the actual assembly of the crane begins. This involves securing the base of the crane onto the foundation. Next, the mast sections, or the tower, are brought in and pieced together, often assisted by mobile cranes. The process continues with the addition of the slewing unit, the machinery that enables the crane to rotate. Finally, during the erection process, the jib, the crane's main lifting arm, and the counter jib, which balances the crane's structure, are added. This requires skilled technicians to carefully connect these components, ensuring proper alignment and balance, followed by a series of functional tests. Dismantling a tower crane is a carefully orchestrated procedure, often marking the end of its role at a construction site. It's essentially the installation process in reverse, with the same rigorous safety protocols. Moving a tower crane from one site to another involves significant logistics. The dismantled components are carefully cataloged and loaded onto transport vehicles, often large trucks or trailers, following carefully mapped routes. Special permits are required for these oversized loads. Want to learn more? Contact us. Call 888-501-1355 or visit apcranetraining.com. That's all for now. See you in the future.